Hey folks, Andy here and welcome to Designer's Universe. Recoloring your graphics in Adobe Illustrator can be a really time-consuming task. So, to make your life easier as a graphic designer, I'm gonna show you my preferred ways to recolor my graphics, ranking them from less to more precise. For this tutorial, I'll be using this very colorful background. Since it has all these colors and a lot going on, I think it'll be perfect for this. First method will be simply converting your colors to black and white or inverting them. I grouped these two together because, to be honest, I almost never use them. I think they serve very specific purposes and they are both pretty straightforward. For both processes, you just need to select the artwork you want to apply the color change, then go to the Edit menu, then Edit Colors. First, let's apply the Convert to Grayscale. And as you can see, it doesn't even have any kind of controls or options to choose. You click on it and it'll make your art black and white. And then the same thing applies to the Invert Colors option. You just click on it and it's done. Next on the list, we have Saturate. You'll find this option on the same menu, in Edit, Edit Colors, then it'll be the last option. This option now gives you a slider to control how much saturation is added or removed. Now, if you have a good eye, you'll notice that reducing saturation to negative 100, making the artwork black and white, does not yield the same result as using the Convert to Grayscale option. That is because the Saturate option is actually just like changing the saturation slider when working on HSB color mode, while Convert to Grayscale will take other factors into account to make a more accurate black and white image. Not gonna go into details, but generally, Convert to Grayscale yields better results for creating black and white images. In the third method, we'll play around with color balance. This will be the first option that will give us a little bit more control. It's located in the same menu and will open this panel right here. Those of you that are also Photoshop users will feel right at home. At the very top, you can choose the color mode you'll be working with: Grayscale, RGB, CMYK, or Global Colors. We'll talk about Global Colors in a little bit. For now, I'll stick to RGB. You can also use this panel to convert your artwork into Grayscale by choosing it on the drop-down menu and checking the Convert option. Now, on these sliders here is where the magic happens. Since I'm working in RGB mode, I have only 3 sliders, one for each color channel. But if you're working with CMYK, then you'll have 4. To understand how these work, think of them as adding or removing that specific color. If I push the red channel to the left, I'm removing red from all of my colors. If I push it to the right, I'm adding red. The same goes for all 3 channels and also for CMYK. It is a little bit tricky to get the results you want, but a little practice can go a long way here. Try messing around until you think you hit the spot. The fourth method uses global colors. Now we start to get into the very accurate ways of changing our colors. When we work with global colors, we unfortunately will have to change our colors one by one, so it can be a little time consuming if you have too many colors to change. I recommend using this method for a max of 5, maybe 6 colors. You can see here that I'm definitely working with more than 6 colors, but I'll do it anyway, just for demonstration purposes. First, select all the colors that you'd like to change, then open the swatches panel. If you don't have the swatches panel open, you can do it in the window menu by checking the swatches panel there. Then, all you have to do is click on this little folder icon on the bottom of the panel to create a new color group. You can give it a name if you like, but I'll go with the standard. Very important step, make sure to check the Convert Process to Global option. Then just hit OK and your global colors group will be created. You can tell that a color is marked as global when it has this tiny white corner. Then, all you have to do is double click on a swatch and change its color. All objects filled with that color will automatically change as you change the swatch. That's why it's called a global color. Last, but definitely not least, there's the Recolor Artwork method. This tool has so many options and functions that it deserves its own video, so maybe I'll go more in depth in the future, but for today, we'll take a brief look over it. Just the same as the first three methods, you can open it through the Edit menu. At first, we are greeted with the simplified version of the panel. Right at the top, we can choose a color library to recolor our graphics with. One of the most useful, in my opinion, are the color books, which we can use to quickly convert a CMYK color to its closest Pantone equivalent. Below the color libraries, we can reduce the amount of colors that we have in the selected artwork if we wish so, but I'm gonna stick to all for now. Right in the middle of the panel, there's this big color wheel, which we can use to quickly change the hue and saturation of all the selected colors. If you want to move them independently, you can just unlink them by clicking on this chain icon. And with this slider on the very bottom, we can adjust the brightness of our colors. On top of the color wheel, we have these very cool randomizers to play with. The first one will randomize the color order, and the second one will randomize the brightness and saturation. You can play with all these options if you're looking for more artistic freedom or just to experiment with your colors, but if you want a little more control over individual colors, you can click on the advanced options and it will open the full panel. I'm not gonna go much into this because there is a lot going on here. A lot of the functions stay the same, but you can now edit individual colors. Just select them on this panel and change them as you see fit. If you mess up with everything, you can always click on the reset button on the top of the panel. Then, when you're happy with the results, just hit OK and that's it. So, those were 5 different ways to recolor your graphics on Adobe Illustrator. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, make sure to like and subscribe to the channel. If you have any suggestions regarding my content, make sure to leave your thoughts in the comment section below. Thank you for watching, and I see you on the next video.